Hello everyone, here are the latest market news on April the 28th, 2020. Oil falls below $11 as USO sells its holdings. Crude oil extended its drop below $11 per barrel on Tuesday after the biggest oil exchange-traded fund unexpectedly began selling all its holdings of the most active contract amid rapidly dwindling storage capacity. U.S. West Texas Intermediate crude futures traded 12.8% lower at $11.14 on Tuesday, marking a $10.64 during the session. WTI plunged 25% on Monday. Brent crude futures declined to a low of $18.85. and were less down 4.3% at $19.14 a barrel. The benchmark slid 6.8% on Monday. The United States Oil Fund LP sold all of its West Texas Intermediate June contracts, significantly widening the spread between July WTI and raising concerns of a repeat of the collapse that sent oil below zero for the first time ever last week. U.S. producers have started making crude deliveries to the nation's emergency stockpile as storage space runs out. Consumer confidence in France marks biggest drop. The INSEE statistics agency reported on Tuesday that French consumer confidence suffered its biggest ever monthly drop in April, when the country was locked down to contain the coronavirus epidemic. The country's monthly consumer confidence index fell to its lowest level since January 2019, dropping to 95 from 103 in March, the steepest monthly decline since INSEE started its survey in 1972. Meantime, French labor market showed fast shrinking despite state-subsidized furloughs designed to avoid mass permanent layoffs, with more than one of every two private sector workers covered by the program. Nissan forecasts its first annual loss since 2009. Japanese automaker Nissan Motor Co. on Tuesday said it expected to report its first annual operating loss in 11 years as the company struggles to recover from plunging vehicle sales as the coronavirus pandemic has slowed demand for cars. Japan's number two automaker said that it expected an annual operating loss of as much as 45 billion yen, $419.7 million, down from a previous forecast announced in February for an operating profit of 85 billion yen. Nissan added that it would delay announcing its annual financial results and restructuring plan to May the 28th. The car giant said in a statement it anticipates additional time to finalize the results and is currently reviewing the precise financial impact. New Zealand relaxes COVID-19 restrictions. New Zealand has started to relax its strict lockdown, with residents able to travel to work, spend more time outside, and order takeaway food for the first time in more than 4 weeks. Schools around the country will open on Wednesday, but Jacinda Ardern, the Prime Minister, said very few children was expected to attend, as she was advising anyone who could work from home or study from home to do so. Meanwhile, PM was forced to clarify that her country is working towards COVID-19 elimination after a number of international publications on Monday ran prominent headlines that New Zealand was the first country in the world to eradicate the disease. New Zealand has reported 1,122 confirmed cases of COVID-19 up to Tuesday, including 19 deaths, one of the lowest tallies in the world. 82% of all confirmed and probable cases has recovered, and 9 people were being treated in hospital, 1 in ICU.